Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about the exponents. So first I will consider a number 5, I will multiply for 3 times. So we will write it as 5 cube, 5, and the up we have to write it as 3. Now this we read it as 5 is raised to the power 3. So we will read this as 5 power 3 is, we should read it as 5 is raised to power 3. So here in 5 raised to the power 3, here 5 is base and 3 we call it as exponent, or we have one more name for the exponent, that is index. So here 5 is a base and 3 is nothing but exponent or index. So similarly, I will consider one more example, minus 6 I am multiplying for 4 times. So we will get it as minus 6 I am multiplying for 4 times, so the power will be 4, and we will read this as minus 6 is raised to the power 4, and here this minus 6 we call it as base and 4 we call it as exponent or index. So this type of notation is known as exponential notation. Here we have this 5 to the power of 3 and minus 6 to the power of 4. This notations we call it as exponential notations. We call it as exponential notations or power notations. So we will go for rational numbers now. Suppose in general I will consider one rational number a by b, and the power, whole power I am taking as 2. So we have power 2, that means numerator and denominator we should multiply for 2 times. So a into a, in the numerator I multiply for 2 times, and b also in the denominator, b into b. So just now we discussed a into a, the power notation for a into a is nothing but a square. And the power notation for b into b is nothing but b square. Similarly, I will consider one more example, a by b and whole to the power of 4. Here we have the whole power 4, so a should be multiplied for 4 times. A into a into a into a, and the denominator also we should multiply b for 4 times. So the power notation for the numerator is a to the power of 4, and the power notation for the b is b to the power of 4. So if we continue this process, we will get it as in general a by b whole to the power of n, we will get it as a to the power of n by b to the power of n. This is a general notation for the rational numbers. Now we will do some problems to know how to evaluate and how to form into the exponential form. Now we will discuss about how to evaluate these exponents. So these are the two examples I consider. First I will solve the first one. We have first one as 3 by 4 whole to the power of 3. So I consider one rational number, that is 3 by 4, and the whole power is 3. So how to evaluate this one? So in the solution, here whole power is 3. So that means the numerator 3 and the denominator 4 we should multiply for equal times. That means 3 times. 3 into 3 into 3. Now same as usual, in the denominator we have 4. 4 also we should multiply by 4 3 times. 4 into 4 into 4. So multiply all these numbers, or we can write in the exponential form also, that 3 to the power of 3 and 4 is raised to the power 3. So if we know the general form, a by b whole to the power of n is equal to a to the power of n and b to the power of n. So we considered into this form, and we can multiply these 3 numbers also. 3 times if we do, we will get it as 27, and 4 cube is nothing but 64. So we can write in the both the forms, and we will go to the next example, that is minus 2 by 3 whole to the power of 4. Similarly, here we have the whole power as 4, so minus 2 we should multiply it for 4 times. Minus 2 into minus 2 into minus 2 minus 2, and the denominator 3 we should multiply it for 3 times. 3 3 we should multiply by 4 times, sorry, 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. Here, in the numerator, if you observe, we have minus signs. So minus sign, if you multiply by the 4 times, it will become positive. And 2, we should multiply it as, we should write it as 2 to the power of 4 by, here denominator also same as it is, 3 to the power of 4. So if I multiply 2 for 4 times, 2 2s are 4 and 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16 and 3 3s are 9, 9 3s are 27, 27 3s are 81. So this is how we have to evaluate the exponential rational numbers. Now we will go for the second example, that is minus 2 by 3 whole to the power of 4. Here the power is 4. So the numerator and the denominator we should multiply it for 4 times. That is minus 2 I should multiply for 4 times. And the denominator 3 also we should multiply it for the 4 times. So the exponential notation for the numerator is minus 2 to the power of 4. That means minus 2 to the raised to the power 4. Next denominator same, 3 is raised to the power 4. Next, so minus 2 if I multiply for the 4 times, we will get it as 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 16. And 3 if I multiply for the 4 times, we will get it as 81. So this is how we should evaluate the exponential rational numbers. Now we will come to learn how to convert rational numbers in exponential form. So I considered one example, 81 by 256. So first to convert into exponential form, we should consider numerator and denominator both separately. We should take it as LCM. So 81. So 81, that is 3, 3 27 times is 81 and 3 9 times is 27 and 3 3 times is 9. So the exponential form for 81 is, so what are the factors first of all? 81 we have 4 factors, 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. So 81 I will write it as 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. Similarly, if I do the denominator 256, I will resolve into factors, equal factors, same, 4. 464 times is 256 and 416 times is 64 and 44s and 41 times. Here also we got 4 for 4 times. That means 4 into 4 into 4 into 4. So in the first step what I did, I resolved 81 and 256 into factors. So after that we have 3 4 times. 3 to the power of 4. So I am writing in the exponential form. That means here also in the denominator we have 4, I multiply to the 4 times, the exponential form for this denominator is 4 to the power of 4. So again 3 by 4, we have equal powers, 4, 4. So we should write it as 3 by 4 whole to the power of 4. So this is the process how to convert rational numbers into the exponential form. Now I will consider one more example, that is 32 by 243. So first step, we should convert the numerator and denominator, we should resolve them into factors. So to resolve them into factors, we should consider the LCM for the numerator 32. So we know that 2 16 times is 32 and 2 8 times is 16 and 2 4 times is 8 and 2 2 times is 1 and 2 1 times 2. So we got the factors now. Total we have 2 5 times. So we should write it as in the numerator 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. So I wrote this all 2s on the numerator. Now I will consider one more number, that is denominator 243. Same, we should convert them into factors. So we will go with 3, 3 8 times and 381 times is 243 and next 3 27 times is 81 and 3 9 times is 27 and 3 3 times is 1 and 3 1 time is 3. So here we got the same 3 5 times as a factor. So these factors I am writing in the denominator, 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. Now in the numerator I am writing this full 2 5 times in the exponential form, that is 2 to the power of 5. And similarly in the denominator, 3 I multiplied for 5 times, the power notation for the denominator is 3 to the power of 5. So total we can see the powers are same in the numerator and denominator, so we can write it as 2 by 3 whole to the power of 5. So This is how we should convert the rational number into an exponential form.